June 14th, 2015. You hear our early detection, other than the alarm. You can't open the front or back door or window without some sounds. I don't care how quiet you try to be. It's specifically designed now. One of those doors open up and you're gonna hear creaking no matter how slow you try it. Plus the alarms that set on the doors and the windows. So the alarm comes on almost instantaneously. Gives me about a second and a half to go live, I guess you'd say. The peppers out here. Again, a lot of people maybe they're buying peppers that are in plants, but see, they've been growing them in hothouses and greenhouses. So their peppers are about twice the size of this. These all were from seed in the house. Started them at the end of March. Actually about the second week of April. And then, see, like this one here is just not seeming to get any bigger than that. You know, I mean, it's got everything the same, all the rest of them are out here, but that might be, see, I got probably three different types of peppers out here. Green bell peppers, cayenne pepper, and habanero, I think. No, not habanero. Well, I didn't like that. But there's probably three peppers out here. As you can see, they look similar, but they're different. But that one is so small. There's one right there that's not really large. The heavy rains we had here, one of them actually washed out. They got a small one over there. But water and baking soda is a very decent, more natural, as you would say, disease control solution. I sprayed the zucchini before and it all just about went completely away. A little bit of what looks like a little, looks like flour or powder on the leaves, but a little bit coming back, as you can see. But see, some of the other zucchini now, it's probably more from insects than anything else, but I just gave this a good dose of some baking soda and water out here. Filled up one of those typical spray bottles, 32 ounce. And then, see, like I say, see that right there? I sprayed everything out here as far as zucchini goes. But they're still producing pretty good. We've been getting them, we got to a point where right now we're giving, you know, 4 to 6 away to people constantly. You see my beans here, my black eyed peas rather. You know, they're branching out here. Until, see, like next year we have, if it grows half as good as this, we still have a pretty good idea how we're gonna fix this. That first one is a purple hull pea. It's a pea onto its own because it's hard to get from heirloom places. My mom had these when she was growing up. She used to pick purple hull peas. My grandmother had them, and I got seeds from her, basically peas. And I tried planting them before, but see, this year is when the garden is really taking off nice. I want to say it's for the plastic. There's three purple hull peas right here and this one here. But see, there's like 2 or 3 plants in each station. So when I say 3 or 4, there's probably about 10 to 12, 14 purple hull pea plants. And you see how they're reaching out, and I've got these strings with these cages. All first time of doing all this, so I've had them before, but I never had them grow out. So I just had one plant. But you can see how this is all branched out here. This is the honeydew. There's 2 different honeydew types. And I was just out here because I saw a couple small honeydews on the stem as it comes off here. Saw that one. Well, there's the other one. Oh, geez, I'm slipping on the plastic. You see the little bulbs down there? Those are going to be honeydews. This one here has had 1 or 2, maybe not. I know I got watermelon out here. If you look at the cucumber is another thing. We underestimated that big time. Look at how it's taken over here. Let me back up. Look how that is just overtaking that whole area there. I mean, I was thinking, this is a lot right here, this watermelon here. It's got a couple watermelons on it starting. Boy, I mean, we're going to have quite a few watermelons, quite a few honeydews or cantaloupes, if you want to call them. I'm not gonna look right now, but I saw two or three. Oh, there's one right there. So I can zoom in on it. It's underneath the crack on the viewfinder right there. See that? Oh, there's a big one in there. Not a big one, but a bigger one than that. See that one there? That's about, that's a little, that's bigger than a golf ball, that one is. So, yeah. The cucumbers are spreading out. The beans here, I think this is my canola bean. Canola runner bean here. But see, I could have sworn that's what, I didn't plant purple pole beans over here, but we plant them over there and they're the same as these over here. So these are my canola beans, canola runner beans. And the ones with the purple are purple pole beans. Oh, damn. And the cucumbers, we already had so many cucumbers. My wife made 5-quart jars of dill pickles. 5 quarts and a pint. And there's my runner beans. 5 quarts and a pint. And see, these things, when I was a kid, I used to think going down there you might have a snake, but that's on grass. I don't know, on plastic. There's bees. There are a lot of bees out here pollinating these flowers, which is really cool. Big bees too. I can hear them buzzing. See, I used to think reaching down there you get a snake, but on the plastic I don't know so much. Now there's one right there. Let me see if I can zoom in on it. Again, I have to go under the viewfinder to see it. Shoot, now I can't see it. My good myself. I think I'm on it though. But there are bees all over these now, which is cool. These will start producing a lot of beans and such. The purple pole beans, we've picked a basket and a half full already. The okra, I think I counted 30 okra plants over there. Because in about 4 or 5 positions, I'll show you, there are 2 okra plants growing in there. Right there, you see them too? That's growing out of one area, one spot. Oh, look at that big one right there. That's 2 okra plants, 2 red or burgundy okra. And won't make the mistake of pumpkins. We're not planting pumpkins next year. We planted what we thought was zucchini. Oh, and I gotta be careful here because I'll get tangled up without my brace and I'll fall over. Oh gosh. Yeah, see how the pumpkin's overtaken over here. I had to move the runners out there. I broke one off and went through the sunflowers over there. I just broke it off. And here's your canola, purple pole beans on this string I hooked up between these hummingbird feeders, which has hummingbirds humming around these a lot. But you look at the weather out here, 20% chance of rain. As you can see, it's all overcast, so it's 20% chance of rain. It means it'll probably rain. I replanted my painted pony beans again, 2 beans in each over there, but they're not going to grow in there, I'm quite sure. In that shade with those from that pumpkin. But then I put them down there. Yeah, I can see underneath the crack right there. And right here, where is it? Right there. Those are purple pole beans. This, we think, is a tomato. I'm not sure. Because again, I've made so many trays of 28, 30 of seeds of tomatoes. Because there are 2 tomato plants there. And peppers. These are peppers right here, too. I think that's a tomato though. Swiss chard. But these are the only thing we ever bought in the store. These 4, allegedly, they say they're heirloom beefsteak tomatoes from Kmart in Jackson, Tennessee. You know, and this is the one I planted out here. See this one here, the first one? There's videos, earlier videos you can see about it. But, you know, I used the core of a roll of toilet paper, I guess the lady was saying about keeping bugs off it. It's still down there at the bottom. But that tomato was about the size, almost, well, you saw how small it was, almost about the size of that pepper right there when I put it out here. And to look at this one, it looks healthier than the ones we bought from Kmart. It's a different type, of course. But that's a good looking tomato plant right there. Those are beefsteak from Kmart. They're thick. You know, of course, they were nursery raised before they brought them to the store. But everything we do out here is from seed from Heirloom Solutions. I have 2 of those emperor beans that just don't seem to be wanting to germinate right down there. These here, forget which bean this is. I put 2 down there. I put two right there, and nothing's coming out of that one, but it's coming here. So, June 14th, 2015, a lot of people are just starting their garden, or maybe have got it out for a couple weeks, but ours has grown up already, and we've been picking from them already. Just the beans haven't come. We've had some purple pole beans we've picked out, like I said, basket and a half. No okra yet. A lot of cucumbers. No watermelons or cantaloupe or honeydew yet. And again, no purple hull peas or black-eyed peas yet. And tomatoes, that's my big thing. Everybody grows tomatoes and peppers, so. Okay, you know, you've seen the small pepper plants, how small they are, and how small these tomato plants are. This is almost as big as anything we bought from the store. And that was grown inside. All of my stuff is started inside. Just these only four here are the only ones that were bought. Everything else started inside, with the exception of maybe like the sunflowers. I dropped too many too. Those are torch sunflowers. You look at the big leaf on them. I just dropped a bunch of seeds around the border. I didn't know what they look like when they come out. But you can see how big it is. They're like soft. The leaves are soft compared to the torch sunflower. I mean, not torch, Titan sunflower. These are your typical sunflower most people have. Just a basic sunflower. This torch are, like I say, bigger flower. These will be like an orange flower. They won't have seeds. They have those petals, like, that's what you plant. These will have the head of seeds. And there's probably about, I'd say about 100 or better. There's ones on the north end of the garden over there. Those over there were eaten up by deer. Almost the whole 4 or 5 feet to the left are the shorter ones. The heads were all eaten off. And I was gonna plant more. I planted a few more. There's some small ones growing, but then look at, they all came back. So the wind out here and the storms have caused those right there. Look at the sunflowers there. They weren't as thick as the ones on the north side, but they were a lot better than this. There's some of them, they're bent over and they're growing up, and I'm not gonna rip them up. I just let them keep going. I dropped a few seeds over here anyway. We got a lot of sunflowers, which is good. Have a lot of seeds next year. If even 50% of what comes out the seed, we have enough to go around this garden four times with the seeds to plant. And this is 55 feet from west to east, and about 45 feet north to south. Okay, so things are gonna be moved around next year too. Now, like I say, if it even comes out 65% like it did this year, we're still gonna have this rearranged differently, and we know how to get it more. So everything's too close together now. We didn't expect it to come out this year. And if it doesn't make as good of a harvest next year, it'll do decent, because we'll have a lot this year. So, I mean, this wind, you think the wind is still my bad? I said, all my pepper plants, when I put them out here, I can't see this really good. About the size of that one there, if that's the pepper, I can't really see it. But I did that, all these here, and look at the wind and the rain just took two of them right out of the ground, and then two back there. I can see it on the viewfinder underneath the crack there, right there. Those two had pepper plants in them too. But the corn has grown up quite a bit. It's about 7-8 feet, a lot of it around us. The downside is it's Monsanto corn. And, you know, I don't like the possible long-time ramifications from that. But, however, at the same token, it is a bit of a wind block. Like I say, next year we're going to have our garden set up a little bit better, a little bit differently, a little bit better. This is the third year we really tried to do anything this year more than the past period. And if the next year's, if we use what we did this year next year, and the country's not gone under dictatorship or any of that crap, you see how that looks right there? All that in the middle. It's going to be like that here. It's going to be like that over there. Pumpkins over there. We're not going to be any more pumpkins. We're not going to put pumpkins down. Okra will be over there. Tomatoes will be about where they're at on that side of the string, and this side of the string rather. Over here, a couple rows of peppers. Cucumbers over here. Zucchini over here, or vice versa. Like I say, it's going to be set up really nice. It's going to be a full garden again. So, that's it.